Is the green product you just bought actually environmentally friendly? Or is a company misleading you with false claims to get your money? Well, it might be the latter, which is also known as greenwashing. You've probably heard the term, but greenwashing is a form of misleading marketing that makes you, the consumer, believe companies are doing more to protect the environment than they actually are. Like when a company releases a new green program or product, but the core of the business is still polluting or completely unsustainable. So today, we're gonna go over how to spot greenwashing and how to find products that are actually environmentally friendly. The term greenwashing was first coined in 1986 by environmentalist Jay Westervelt after he saw a beach resort asking guests to reuse towels in order to reduce ecological damage and help protect the oceans and reefs. But the irony was that the resort was in the middle of an expansion, which means they'd be damaging the ecosystem themselves. Westervelt then went on to write about it in a term paper, which then turned into an essay for a literary magazine, and that's when the term caught on. But one of the earliest examples of greenwashing dates back to the 60s, when the electrical company Westinghouse released an ad campaign proclaiming nuclear power plants were clean and safe for the environment. Those ads were also released right after two nuclear meltdowns in Michigan and Idaho. The ads also ignored anything in regards to nuclear waste. Nowadays, being sustainable is something more people care about. So much so that 47% of American consumers are willing to pay more for sustainable products, according to a 2019 survey. But greenwashing still remains prominent in corporate marketing. Companies like Nestle, Shell, BMW, and General Electric were all accused of greenwashing over the past 20 years. So how can you, the consumer, look out for these kinds of false claims and buy products that are actually eco-friendly? Well, here are three ways you can look for red flags. Number one, be a skeptic. If something reads like it's too good to be true, then it probably is. For example, a lot of companies will advertise their products as 100% biodegradable or recyclable. But what they don't put on the label is that it's only biodegradable or recyclable if it's discarded properly and weathered in the right conditions. So this type of greenwashing captures consumers through lack of transparency and informational context, leaving you to put in the extra work to figure out if the product is as green as they claim. Other labeling jargon to look out for and question include terms like sustainable, socially responsible, eco-friendly, and recycled content. If you see these words, don't just assume it's true. Look for additional certification on the label to make sure the claim is verified. Which brings us to our second step. Look for certified eco-labels. Some eco-labels will also include badges of approval from Fairtrade, the EPA, Safer Choice, Green Seal, and B Corporation certification, amongst many more. These assessments signify that the product has met a specific criteria and that it meets federal or international regulation standards. But if there's an eco-label you don't recognize, you can always go online and cross-reference it. Websites like Ecolabel Index tracks over 400 ecolabels in 199 countries. So you can look up what each ecolabel means, the process behind its certification, and what products are labeled with it. And our final step is do your research. A clear sign of companies greenwashing is when they really make you work for the information you're looking for. If you can't find any certification or the product label is vague, like saying, it's good for the planet, but they don't say how, then there's probably a hidden trade-off. Invest some time in going to the company's website and looking for proof of green efforts. Or look at the ingredients list for toxic chemicals or pollutants. You can also consult with third-party organizations like Greenpeace, CorpWatch, and the FTC, which all keep tabs on companies and products that may have a record of greenwashing. And if you need a quick reference point, you can use apps like Ecolabel Guide, Think Dirty, and How Good. These apps let you scan or look at products to see how green and safe they actually are. So as you can see, greenwashing is all about misleading information. Sometimes it's unintentional, but most times it's not. And while some companies are trying to adopt better sustainable practices, the bulk of the work still mostly comes down to you, the consumer. Being a good, conscious consumer is hard work. But if being environmentally friendly is something you're passionate about, the best way to avoid getting greenwashed is just to do your research.